Hi, welcome back to Answering ATPL. In this ATPL question bank video series for general navigation subject, I'm going to show you how to solve this great circle track question. We will solve this question using illustration and calculation method. The focus of this channel is to provide explanation for ESA ATPL examination and other aviation related stuff. If this is your first time here, consider subscribing to Answering ATPL by clicking on the subscribe button and click on the bell icon to get notified when I publish a new video. You are flying from A, 50 degree north, 10 degree west, to B, 58 degree north, 2 degree east. If the initial great circle track is 047 degree true, what is the final great circle track? The optional answer are A, 52 degree, B, 43 degree, C, 57 degree, and D, 29 degree. To solve this type of question, we need to illustrate the question before solving it. However, there is a better and faster method to solve this type of question. Make sure you stay to the end of the video as I'm going to show you how to answer this type of question in short amount of time. On the top left-hand corner of the screen is the data given by the question. To illustrate, we need to draw the longitude line first. For Northern Hemisphere, all longitude line is converging toward North Pole. Here is the picture taken from Google Earth. As you can see, all the longitude line are converging toward North Pole. On the left is 10 degree west and on the right is 2 degree east. Next, we need to draw the latitude. The convention of drawing latitude is, in the Northern Hemisphere, latitude line concave toward North Pole. The bottom one is 50 degree north and the top one is 58 degree north. Here is point A and here is point B. The great circle track is the closest track between two points. It is marked as green line on the screen. Rhumb line is a track where you maintain constant heading throughout the journey and marked by the red line on the screen. By the way, if you want to learn more on great circle and rhumb line, please check out my previous video on the subject. The link is available in the description. For this question, we will not need the rhumb line because we were already given the initial great circle track from A to B. The initial great circle track is 047. The question asks us to find the final great circle track. To find the answer, we need to find the difference between these two angles. The difference between these two angles is known as convergency. Convergency equals change of longitude times sine mean latitude. Change of longitude is the difference between start longitude and end longitude. Thus, change of longitude equal 10 degree west minus 2 degree east, change of longitude equals 12 degree. To understand this, let's take a look at this diagram. We are traveling from 10 degree west to 2 degree east. We will cross the prime meridian en route. That means we will fly 10 degree in the western quadrant and 2 degree in eastern quadrant. Thus, the total change in longitude is 12 degree. Next, we need to find mean latitude. Mean is also known as average. Mean latitude equal 50 plus 58 divided by 2. Mean latitude equal to 54 degree. Now, let's plug in this value into convergency formula. Convergency equal 12 times sine 54. Convergency equal 9.7 degree. Looking at the diagram, we can see that great circle track at B is larger than great circle track at A. That means great circle track at B equals great circle track at A plus convergency. Great circle track at B equals 47 plus 9.7. Great circle track at B equals 56.7 degree. The closest answer is C. Now, let's take a look on how to answer this type of question first. Here is the question. The first key point in the question is 50 degrees north. From this key point, we know that the location referred by the question is in the northern hemisphere. For this type of question, we will need DIID diagram. Since we know that the location referred by the question is in the northern hemisphere, we will only need the top half of this diagram. If you want further explanation on DIID diagram, please watch my previous video titled Great Circle, Small Circle, Rhumb Line and Convergency. The link is available in the description below. D in this diagram means decrease, whereas I means increase. The next key point in this question is initial great circle track is 047 degrees true. By looking at this data, we know that we are traveling toward easterly heading, marked by yellow arrow in the diagram. By using this data, we can now conclude that the great circle track at A is less than the great circle track at B. We have now reduced the possible answer to two answers, 52 degree and 57 degree. There are only two more steps to be done. First, calculate conversion and then add conversion value to the great circle track at A. Which method do you prefer? Please let me know in the comment section below. What do you think of this video? Please let me know in the comment section below. And if you find the video beneficial, please like it and share with others. By doing so, you will help other people to find the video. If you want to learn more about ATPL or other aviation related stuff, subscribe now by clicking the round subscribe icon. Please check out my other video by clicking on the rectangular box. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.